You've been bitten. The itch to make movies consumes your every thought. Yet your parents are skeptical. Is this a phase? Is it for life? Can you really make a living making movies? Should you research film schools or go to a state school and study something more financially feasible? This isn't a choice to be made lightly, but for the sake of simplifying the discussion, let's just assume that you're sure you want to be involved in the film industry for your future career. How do you actually approach this? First, it's important to think past the goal most people have of being a writer-director with complete creative control. Lol. This position, while powerful, is not suited to every personality type, and you may find yourself trying to plug yourself into something that you ultimately won't enjoy. There are so many career paths on, off, and relating to a film set, that you can be sure there's something there for you. Actors need costumes and makeup, cameras need directors and operators, the film needs sound, music, and don't even get me started on the gigantic array of possible careers in post-production or VFX. Also consider this, many of these roles have counterparts in animation or gaming. There is a galaxy of future roles, so really explore and find the thing that most directly lines up with your specific passions and personality. Once you have several specific possibilities in mind, you're faced with a choice. Should you go to an art or film school, or should you self-study? Now, both these options are entirely valid pathways into the industry, and there are very intense opinions, negative and positive, from a plethora of people on these topics, but both options aren't right for every person. There is no right or wrong. No matter which path you take, the end goal is still the same. You want to be good at what you do, and you want proof of your skill. Each option I'll present is a different way to build those skills and learn to market yourself and build a solid demo reel and portfolio as an endgame. First, let's tackle art or film school. A factor of supreme importance here is that you cannot go with the closest or cheapest option. Figure out what segment of the film industry you think you would like to master and do your homework. Research what schools teach that specific subset of skills the very best. From this list, you can then reorder the schools based on price and proximity. Going with the cheapest option is only going to leave you lacking the actual skills you need and floating in a sea adrift with no clue how to market yourself. Let's look at some of the benefits of choosing this higher education option. A major benefit is structure. Your courses will be set up in a manner that facilitates a step-by-step walkthrough of the skills and techniques you need. Before signing off on a school, ask about this path. See if you can get a breakdown of your learning arc. A good school will usually have this on their website, and it'll give you an idea of where the gaps in your current knowledge may be. A specialized school will pack more relevant courses into your degree rather than forcing things like foreign language or advanced mathematics upon you. Structured learning can be frustrating at times. People might not always agree with your artistic ideas. You may spend time learning things you don't think you need. But there's no doubt in my mind that you'll learn faster and learn more when you're nudged to see things from different perspectives. Being able to see things from multiple perspectives is a critical skill you'll need to develop if you want to be a good film director. Film schools also offer you the opportunity to get honest feedback. It'll be frustrating to be criticized by an instructor or by your peers at first, but this process sharpens your skills, thickens your skin, and prepares you for the big stage. My school was pretty conservative about the approach to production, which gave us a good sense of the way things are traditionally supposed to be done. I've often departed from the way we learn to do things in school, but having that foundation has informed my choices in a way that I've found very useful. The second and most important thing was meeting many of the people who have become my longtime collaborators. Now, speaking of collaboration, later in life you will be hard-pressed to find such a wide variety of diversity, talent, and the willingness to help out with your film as you will while in school. Outside of film school, you may never have the opportunity to work with so many different collaborators or to safely make the many mistakes that are part of the process. Failure, confusion, and strife cost you more in the real world, if only because they don't have the candy shell of education around them. Art or film school can be a really great time to experiment with your style and technique in a constructive environment. It can also provide safety for those who've already begun careers in other fields but would like to switch over. If you look at the major players and smaller players, many went to film school. I went to film school. Why? Because I was already married and I couldn't afford to go down to LA and try and make it. Also, I wasn't aspiring to make Bad Boys 3 or make $100 million in a weekend as a filmmaker. I think if you want your mind expanded and you want to look at film in a deeper way than Hollywood allows, then yes, film school is a good choice. For those wanting to make the next big films, then NYU, USC, UCLA, those are the schools you need to look at. The smaller schools are for people who want want to be in control of their careers as they grow. Depending on who you ask, researchers currently contend that it takes anywhere from 10,000 to 20,000 hours of practice in anything to achieve mastery. Whether those numbers are perfectly accurate is moot. The takeaway is that filmmaking, like painting, athletics, playing the piano, or science, takes a massive amount of time and dedication to master. In exchange for tuition, film school will give you structured time in which to practice your craft in a safe, constructive environment. This is perhaps the greatest gift a school can offer. Now, those are pretty good reasons to choose higher education, yet make no mistake, there are plenty of drawbacks too. All this safety we talked about can end up being an echo chamber, or a bubble. One thing film school does not give you is an understanding of how audiences will respond to your work. I feel like that's missing from a lot of folks who have the deep film school straight into production type experience. What may work on student projects may be a strict taboo on a film set. What resonates with art students may not be appreciated by general audiences. There's a pretty big gap between your university experiences and actual professional context. Also, a problem with film school is that you start at the bottom, doing things you may feel you're overqualified to do after 4 years of higher education. And that's not gonna pay super well, which is a problem, because art or film school is unbelievably expensive. It has never been more expensive to go to film school, and it has never been cheaper to make a movie. Finally, unlike lawyers or dentists, the vast majority of filmmakers don't make a lot of money. Offsetting the cost of your student loan is a lot harder when you can't bill $500 an hour for a legal consultation, or $2,000 for putting a crown in someone's mouth. Often it takes years of grunt, free, or spec work to work your way up to a well-paying film gig. Paradoxically, what this means in practice is that a lot more lucrative non-film jobs are gonna end up looking more attractive after you graduate from film school because of the debt you created while pursuing your expensive film degree. Being forced to pay back huge student loans is the last thing an aspiring filmmaker should have to face. There has never been a time in human history where it's been easier to make films with no formal education. Hardware is cheap. Your phone has a better camera than a consumer could afford in their wildest dreams 10 years ago. Software is easier to learn than ever, and most major packages have gigantic user groups, forums, and tutorials online available for free. Most major software also has free personal learning editions of the software, so you can even learn it completely legally without cracking anything. Spending time shooting films and learning at your own pace without spending a bundle you don't have on an expensive education may sound ideal as well, but it also has some pretty serious drawbacks. First, we're gonna start with the positives to this idea of learning on your own. It's true, mastery of a field is a result of time spent, not money spent. I am sure there are a lot of things I could have learned in film school, and sometimes I'm jealous of my friends who went. I know I beat my head against problems that someone could have simply explained to me in a school setting, and there are probably holes in my film education. But ultimately, whether you go to film school or not, there's no substitute for going out and spending hundreds of hours trying to make a film. I believe the best way to learn how to make a film is, quite simply, to make a film. Not only will you have made something that is your calling card, but you'll meet your first set of real-world collaborators. It's an invaluable experience that I'm not sure can be properly gained in the classroom. They can teach you in school how to say what you're going to say, but they can't teach you what to say. With the six figures you're likely spending on film school, what would happen if you instead spent that time traveling the world, reading books, doing odd jobs, or volunteering work and meeting people along the way? Your perspective on the world is so much more important than any amount of craft or production value. Conceptually, this notion is really compelling. However, in practice, most people don't have the inner strength to focus on their chosen aspect of filmmaking in a manner that would compete with schooling in terms of final result. When you educate yourself without film school and without a mentor, you must create the curriculum. You must develop the ability to honestly critique your own work. Good luck with that one. And you need to know when to shift your focus to another set of skills, constantly transitioning from the role of instructor to student and back again. The obvious cost of a self-directed DIY filmmaking study program is that setting up a study structure takes a lot of time and an exceptional amount of discipline. But the real costs could be the lack of opportunities that come as a result of not having a network of classmates. So there you go, positives and negatives to both approaches. As a final word, I would like to personally reiterate a caution to anyone choosing the film school route not to settle on the cheapest option. You are absolutely wasting your time and money. Find the right school for you with the right curriculum and the right teachers. Do not settle for anything less. You're already going to be bleeding loan money, and you should just embrace it if that's the choice you've made. Study hard, don't party, don't drink, don't waste your time. Work on your craft as though it is the only thing that matters in life. Your future will thank you. To anyone choosing to go it alone, alone without formal education. Look at demo reels of those in your chosen film. To be competitive, you need to get to that level. Look at qualifications for open positions at production houses, VFX houses, and animation studios relating to your area of pursued expertise. You need to know all these skills. Pursue it doggedly. Work a part-time job if you can. Live with your parents if you can. Show them constant progress. Get someone to hold you accountable. Give them a lesson plan and have them review your projects as you complete them. Seek out critique and become good at taking the opinions of others and improving as a result. Regardless as to what you choose, best of luck. I cannot wait to see what you do. This has been Cinema Cemetery, digging 6 feet deeper into film and culture.